Welcome back, everybody, to 17 Sports Talk. I'm Justus Rogers here with Omar Perez.
Good morning. Good morning. Good. How you doing? How you doing? Good.
A lot of sports going on this past week, over the weekend.
Sure.
A little overwhelmed with it. Even some natural weather disasters interfering with a few sports events and things like that.
Yeah, of course.
It was a little jam-packed.
A little unpredicted.
Yeah, exactly. But first, we'll start off where we ended last week. Kawhi Leonard has a new home, man. Your San Diego brother.
Oh, goodness. I mean, it's... I'm a Laker fan, but that one stung a little bit. But yeah, he is back in LA in his hometown.
Yeah, exactly. And I thought, you know, as the days got closer and closer to when they were, you know, thinking he was going to make his decision, you know, I was just assuming, you know, it doesn't look like the Lakers are going to get him. And, you know, of course, I would let it have him with LeBron and Anthony Davis and all the other support guys we have. But I was also thinking, the amount of money he wants, we're not going to be able to give him. Our salary, we don't have that much money in the bank, you know, to hand out to him after we just paid, you know, AD and we're paying all these
right.
other guys good money to come and play with LeBron. You know, I just didn't think we had the, you know, the cap for it.
I mean, in my opinion, there were so many reports saying that this guy was a Laker fan, but he came out saying, I believe, a year or two ago saying he didn't grow up a Laker fan. He actually grew up like a Sixers fan, I believe, or an Allen Iverson fan. So people kept saying that was, you know, going to be, was going to bring him home. But,
yeah.
you know, not a surprise. It seemed like... Yeah, you know, it seems like the NBA is balanced now, a lot of people are saying.
Right, yeah, exactly. And I think really it just leaves a hole, you know, with the team he just won his second ring with in Toronto. They're kind of back to where they were before he got there.
I know, and that's crazy what one player can do.
Yeah, and we just talked about it, like I said, last week, how it's kind of this trend where it seems like a lot of players, as far as their loyalty goes to the team that they might have signed with for 1 year or 2 years, you know, once that contract is up, it's kind of out the window now. They're looking to, you know, go to a better team or, you know, have somebody come to their team to better the team they're already on.
Right.
You know, it's really about that ring. And if they can't get the ring, it's about the contract. It's
right.
about, you know, getting that supermax deal that,
Absolutely.
You know, he just got.
Right, right. I mean, I thought his best chance to do all that and to, you know, keep sustained success will be with the Lakers, you know, knowing the legacy that they have, mm-hmm. knowing the players that they have. I mean, LeBron, it seems like he's going to pass the torch on, you know,
right.
to Anthony Davis and whoever may come next. And it seemed like it would have been a fitting, you know, for right. for even a player like Kawhi Leonard to team up with
right.
the, you know, a great player like LeBron James and Anthony Davis. But,
yeah.
you know, the NBA next year is going to be – It's going to be interesting,
yeah.
and the Battle of L.A. is
it's
that
on
much
now.
More intense.
Yeah, it's on. And just to break down, Kawhi Leonard signed for 4 years, $142 million. So he's going to be
bag.
There a while. And
yep.
that's similar to even to what LeBron's deal was like when he first landed in L.A. He's
right.
there for 4 years.
Right.
So it's going to be interesting to see. We have at least 4 years of good face-off between the Clippers and Lakers.
Yep.
And they play in the same arena in the Staples Center. So I'm sure ticket sales are through the roof right now.
Sure.
And, of course, you know, a day later they signed Paul George.
Gosh.
He gets a Supermax contract.
That's crazy.
I mean, you could just imagine. I'm sure they're going to, you know, blend well together on the same team.
And it just seemed like, you know, Kawhi Leonard was really looking for people who were not deficient in their defensive play.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, when you talk about Paul George, he can score, and he's an elite defender.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it seems like, you know, moving forward, you know, going into that type of, you know, role where now he is that guy.
Yeah.
Kawhi Leonard was looking at for someone who can also, you know,
right.
play well with him on the defensive side because Kawhi Leonard is a great defender.
Right, exactly. And it's interesting even just to see with the Clippers, you know, I would say before they signed Kawhi, they were kind of a bare bones team. You know, they had, you know, a nice bench, a few guys here and there, but they weren't, you know, they weren't a lock to be in the playoffs this next coming season or to even, you know, go deep in the postseason. And now you add two of these guys just with the players they already had. You know, I believe they re-signed Patrick Beverley, and they gave him a nice little contract that he deserves. He's obviously one of the, you know, I would say, if not the best, right under Kawhi,
sure.
you know, defensive players in the league, especially
For sure.
at the point guard position. So, I mean, you add that, you know, you've kind of added some potential.
Absolutely. I mean, you talk about Finals MVP and Kawhi Leonard,
mm-hmm.
and I believe right up to, you know, the voting, you know, was finished,
mm-hmm.
Paul George was in that conversation with,
right, for MVP.
With MVP as
yeah,
well. So,
yeah.
I mean, yeah, absolutely. They have the pieces there.
Right.
You know, the Clippers are trying to get there first.
Right.
Lakers trying to get that 17th.
Right, exactly.
So, I mean, there's, you know, there's a lot of expectation on both sides.
Right. Either way, L.A. is going to be rocking when the season gets
absolutely.
Here in October, and, you know, we just can't wait
Nothing
to see
better.
What else. And like I said, free agency is still fresh. It's still new. You know, we still got at least two more months where, you know, guys could sign. That Russell Westbrook is, you
LA
know.
LA man,
is,
you know.
I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like just everybody's trying to, you know, either chase a bag or chase a ring.
Right, exactly. So either way, they're chasing. And, of course, the Lakers weren't finished. You know, they signed DeMarcus Cousins, got him away from the Golden State Warriors last week, and also re-signed Rajon Rondo. So it looks like even after they got Anthony Davis, you know, they're adding more pieces here and there just so that they have a complete team, you know, when the season begins.
And in my opinion, the signing that we don't talk about enough is Alex Caruso. I mean, this point guard was playing, you know,
lights out,
you know, with LeBron.
Yeah.
You know, seems like there was no deficiency in his game. I believe he's shooting 80% at the, field goals at the free throw line. So, you know, this guy is, I believe, a secret weapon that they needed to bring back with.
Yeah.
Although Rajon Rondo and Cook gives you, you know, that depth, my opinion, that's going to be one of the interesting, battles in training camp, which was going to be, you know, who's going to start a point guard for the Lakers?
Right.
Could it be LeBron? I mean, LeBron might be dishing it out.
Yeah, bringing it up. Exactly. You have no idea what that lineup's going to look like. But even I saw online that people were considering Caruso to be like the secret weapon of the Lakers. And, you know, it seems like even last season, every few moments he has a breakout dunk, or he has a crazy shot, or comes up clutch. And, you know, he's just one of those guys that, you know, he's going to come off the bench. He's most likely not going to start unless, you know, somebody's hurt.
Sure.
Or they have to make a change up in the lineup. But he's one of those guys that he kind of completes your team. He's that guy that he's diving on the floor, you know, to get the ball.
Don't be surprised if he starts, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't be surprised if he starts.
Exactly.
I mean, you want players, when you're playing against LeBron, to have as less of deficiency as they can.
Right.
He plays pretty well defensively, too.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. So he's going to be a great piece as well. And a major highlight, I mean, of course, it was interrupted by, the earthquakes that people felt in California and Las Vegas as well, was Zion had his first summer league game against the Knicks. And he had a great
debut.
First half.
Sure.
I mean, he's ripping the ball from guys. He's making
muscling
grown men look like children out there. And, of course, after the first half, it looks like he had some knee-to-knee contact with the player. And they're saying he's going to be out for the rest of the summer league. But from what I saw, you know, I was on him from I'd say, a junior in high school all the way up until this point. And he still seems consistent, even in that first half of summer league. I mean, he looked like, he's ready to play NBA. I mean, would you agree?
I would definitely say. I mean, like you said, it's a grown man's game, and this guy looked grown out there playing and ripping the ball out, dunking it. I mean, it seemed like even in warm-ups it was a spectacle, right? Like kind of like OBJ when he does his one-handers, you know, warm-ups in New York now going to be in Cleveland. But this guy looks ready. He's all the hype, you know what I mean? I think he's ready.
Yeah, and I think it's a smart idea for the New Orleans Pelicans organization to keep him out for the rest of the summer league, just because, you know, he's their number one pick, and you got to take care of your gym. You got to take care of your diamond there.
He's got plenty of basketball to play, so absolutely.
Right, exactly. And like I said, I think it'd be different if he didn't already have such, you know, an impressive physique where, you know, you would need him to either be conditioned or need him to, you know, really get used to banging up against these guys in the NBA. But I think because he's been ready since high school, you know, you could kind of groom him a little bit differently.
Sure.
And obviously, you know, you want to protect him, you know, up until the season gets here. So, you know,
Number one overall pick.
Right.
Yeah. He's expected to play.
Yeah.
You got to keep him healthy.
Exactly. That's your biggest investment, you know, in however many years, you got to take care of him.
Absolutely.
And so, obviously, we won't see him for the rest of this summer, but I'm looking forward to seeing him. I'm sure he'll play in the preseason.
Sure.
And, you know, going into the season, I think he's going to be more than ready, just because, you know, we saw what he did at Duke.
Yeah, absolutely. And you got ballers, you know, that are coming in from the Lakers.
Right.
Brandon Ingram, Lonzo Ball.
Right, yeah.
Josh Hart. They're looking to play. They're looking to prove something with Zion.
Yeah.
You know, debuting as an NBA player, I believe it's going to be exciting.
And they got a nice, like you said, they got a nice young core. So, I mean,
absolutely.
I'm not, you know, believing that they're going to have a long, you know, if they even, you know, get as far to the playoffs. But I think we will see flashes during the season of potential for these young guys.
Because
a lot of them are either second, third, fourth year guys.
Yep.
You know, I want to say the main veteran that will probably be starting will be a Drew Holiday.
Yep.
And he's always been a solid guard. But other than that, you know, it's a young team.
Young team.
So, you know, I believe the sky's the limit for them. It's just, you know, everybody has to stay healthy. And
it takes time. We'll see how the season plays out.
Right, exactly. And then, you know, we'll switch gears now, of course. You know, like I said, it was a sports-packed weekend, and even just going into the weekend, Thursday, Friday. But, of course, on Sunday, we had soccer. We had, you know, I didn't catch the games, but I know you watched.
Right, I saw the women's play in the World Cup against the Netherlands. And, you know, it seemed like it was a battle back and forth.
Yeah.
And with that penalty kick, it just, you know, brought back the Americans, and, you know, women played out and they closed out the tournament.
Yeah.
How they started.
And you watched the entire game.
I watched the entire game, right. From start to finish, you know, it was a good game.
Yeah.
And it kind of, you know, highlights a little bit about the women's whole journey in the World Cup. They dominated out the gates.
Exactly.
And they finished And now they have a fourth star, so they should be absolutely proud.
Yeah, exactly. And I know revolving around a lot of the women's journey throughout this tournament is the conversation around equal pay,
right,
and what the women make. And even I read
pay them.
Right. even I read an article over the weekend saying that at the end of the tournament, you know, it looks like everybody will get like $250,000 or something like that. And then they talked about, you know, when you look over at the men's, you know, they get about $3 million.
It's just even I believe Megan came out in the after in one of the interviews saying asking for equal pay.
Right.
And I believe, you know, this really puts it into perspective, right?
Yeah.
These women are putting their bodies on the line.
Right. Yeah.
You know, traveling around the world, they also have families and stuff like
right,
that.
Exactly.
That pay.
Right.
You know, if we want to start comparing, it shouldn't be a gap. I mean,
right,
the men haven't won the World Cup. These women have won four now.
Right, yeah.
Four World Cup championships. I believe respect is given, needs to be given, and equal pay for sure should be more of a topic of discussion moving forward.
And I agree, and I've always felt that same way, even in the conversation regarding the NBA and WNBA.
Right.
And we talked about it, I want to say, like a week or two ago, where WNBA teams and players were showing that they don't fly private like NBA players and NFL players do. They fly, and they have to sit with, you know, us regular people, you know, in coach or in first class.
Sure.
And, you know, you could be on a flight, you know, to L.A. or San Francisco, and you're sitting next to a professional women's basketball player. And, you know, obviously they're taller and they need leg room and all
that. Yeah, absolutely.
And they're not taken care of the same way, you know, NFL and NBA players are. And they have the same type of career. Like you said, they're putting their bodies on the line.
Yeah, absolutely.
They're training. They're doing all these things.
And some of them are mothers, too. I mean, you talk about, you know, that's something that I believe, you know, having that time off and being paid for that. I believe if this is their profession.
Right. They deserve to be paid accordingly.
Pay them. I mean, they proved it.
Right.
They won the World Cup. They won four now. If you want to put comparison, like I said,
exactly,
the women have out championship, have out, you know,
right,
in a lot of ways, brought more hardware than the men.
And I would even say for those that, you know, would want to play the opposite side or be the devil's advocate, that, you know, a lot of the times the argument for the WNBA versus the NBA was, you know, well, the WNBA, they don't make as much money as the NBA, or they don't bring in as much advertising dollars, where in soccer, because it's a
world sport,
universal, international, everybody watches or plays soccer, you can't, you know, compare the money they bring in, because it's pretty much the same to what the men do.
I mean,
do,
if you know, me being, you know, a man, I mean, I was sitting there, I felt more American pride watching the women play than, you know, the American.
Guys,
and, you know, I mean, and that just tells you what kind of, you know, personnel and what kind of people these women are off the field as
well. Exactly.
They've used that, you know, platform to the best of their ability.
Right.
And I believe they're inspiring, you know, not just little boys, little girls, but
everybody. Yeah.
Absolutely.
And I really wouldn't be surprised if, you know, in the near future, in the next maybe 2 to 3 years, there is a change in, you know, the way and how much women are paid in sports, especially in soccer and the WNBA, those being the more, you know, popular and ones that are on TV that you get to watch on a regular basis.
Right.
But yeah, something definitely needs to be done. And I would even say it's even great that, you know, the players on the team and coaching staff and all that are bringing more attention to it. Because in the past, it didn't seem like that was always the stance where, you know, we knew that, yeah, it's not equal pay as it should be. But I don't think as many people were as vocal about it. And now at least there's a conversation, you know, surrounding it. Because
You got LeBron James, you know, posting his picture with the U.S. women's soccer jersey.
Yeah.
You got The Rock. You know, you got everybody behind these women. And
I believe there's a lot of support.
There's a lot of support. And I believe something should and will be done soon.
Right, exactly. So I definitely, you know, hope that does happen soon, because they definitely deserve it. And, you know, switching over to another football, you know, we are 9 Sundays away from the NFL beginning. I mean, can you feel the hype building already?
I mean, I feel like football like was just yesterday. You know, I'm already ready. You know, I'm already seeing, you know, a lot of these high schools around here in Bakersfield, you know, getting their summers, you know, started with their 2-a-days. You know, we're getting a lot of these, you know, training camps, even from, you know, the NFL,
right,
they're kind of getting started. Yeah, so I mean, people are ready. You know, football is always a big sport here.
Yeah, exactly. And it was just interesting to see that, you know, NBC Sports, on NBC, they're putting out their Sunday Night Football, you know, promos already and whatnot. And it's like, man, is it that time already? And for me,
it's never too early.
Right, exactly. And for me, this is the time of year I'm looking forward to most, just because, you know, when basketball's over, you know, for me, the only really other thing I'm watching is my Dodgers.
Yeah.
And, you know, what else?
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
So now that, you know, football will be back and then basketball will be back, you know, in October officially when the season begins, you know, obviously preseason will start a little bit before that.
Right.
To me, that's the perfect mix. You got baseball, football, basketball,
right?
You know, and then the people that are into their hockey or golf, whatever
hockey,
else,
right?
Everything's going on. You got tennis going on right
Absolutely.
Now, Wimbledon and everything. So,
I mean, we still got great athletes in the NFL, right? I mean, we talk about, you know, one of the greatest quarterbacks of all time, Tom Brady, looking for
playing again.
You know what I mean? We got a lot of, you know, good hype building up to this season,
right? Yeah, yeah.
You know, especially here in LA. I mean, I mean, close to LA, right?
Right. We LA
close
Rams
to LA. We got the Rams. You got the Chargers.
Yeah.
You know, it seems like those teams are both going to be competing for a Lombardi Trophy. So, football season is already seems like it's almost on the way.
Right. Yeah. Exactly. And I think it's obviously too early to start making predictions
sure.
and whatnot. But you know, they also had a crazy, I would say, free agency and you know, a lot of trades, players that were, you know, on teams for, you know, a few years or seemed like they'd be there forever. You know, they switched. You mentioned earlier OBJ going to Cleveland from New York. That's a big switch, not only market-wise, but just personnel-wise. He's over there with Baker Mayfield now.
Seems like Cleveland is building something special.
Yeah, yeah.
They really are.
Yeah, yeah.
So you're right. I mean, it's going to be a lot of excitement. We'll see. And what I love about football is it's not like basketball. It's not like you know, boxing necessarily, where it's a very individualistic sport.
Right,
where
it's team sports.
Where we just saw, you know, Kawhi completely take over a game, and it seemed like he carried that basketball team. But football is such a team sport.
Right, you
can never predict who's going to win, who's going
to
win how much.
Right.
So when you talk about players like Tom Brady who have been winning Super Bowls
For this long,
it's, I mean, it's tip your hat off and, you know, appreciate the game of football, really.
Exactly. So now that we're under, you know, 10 weeks to the NFL season, you know, of course, that coverage is going to get much thicker as, you know, things start and, you know, training camp and all that happens. So I'm sure we'll be able to have some more coverage on that, and that'll be a lot fun to talk about. We'll have, you know, the Cowboys just down the way in Oxnard for training camp. You know, you have the Chargers out there. You have the Rams in Thousand Oaks. So, you know, we're real close to, you know, these NFL teams. You know, you got the Niners and the Raiders up the way in the Bay Area until the Raiders leave, you know, go to Vegas. But, yeah, NFL season coming up. That'll be interesting to talk about. 17 Sports Talk, Justus Rogers.
Omar Perez.
You know, Omar, you know, we'll be back.
We'll be back.
All right. Thank you.